इसरो हैज सेंट चंद्रयान 1 एंड चंद्रयान 2 मिशंस टू स्टडी द मून. रिसेंटली इसरो आल्सो लॉन्च्ड द चंद्रयान 3 मिशन. हाउएवर इसरो हैज नॉट येट कंडक्टेड एन इन डेप्थ स्टडी ऑफ द सन. टू स्टडी सन इसरो इज प्लानिंग टू लॉन्च द आदित्य L1 मिशन ऑन August 26, 2023. द मिशन एम्स टू एनहांस आवर अंडरस्टैंडिंग ऑफ द सन. बट व्हाई इट इज सो इंपॉर्टेंट टू स्टडी द सन. इन आवर कॉस्मोस देयर आर न्यूमरस यूनिवर्सेस एंड गैलेक्सीज each containing a million stars. However, these stars are often located many light years away from Earth, making their direct study virtually impossible. Fortunately, our nearest star is the Sun, situated relatively close to Earth. By studying the Sun, we can understand the intricacies of star formation and gain insights into the life cycle of stars, including their death. This knowledge contributes to a deep understanding of the history of the cosmos. Additionally, the Sun's continuous explosive activity gives rise to solar storms, which have a significant impact on the solar system. Earth, being a part of this system, is prone to these effects. Satellites orbiting Earth can be impacted by these solar storms. Hence, a comprehensive study of the Sun enables us to anticipate and predict these solar storms, thereby mitigating their potential impact. When we examine the interior structure of the Sun, we discover distinct layers. At its core, the Sun harbors a region with a staggering temperature of approximately 15 million Kelvin. Moving outward, there exists a sequence of layers including radiative zone, convection zone, photosphere, and chromosphere. These layers constitute an intermediate zone having temperatures around 10,000 Kelvin. Beyond these layers lies the Sun's outermost region, where temperature soars to around 1 million Kelvin. This raises a question: why does the outer layer of the Sun possess a higher temperature compared to the intermediate layers? ISRO laid the foundation of Aditya L1 mission in 2008. The mission aimed to send a chronograph along with a satellite to study the Sun's corona layer. However, in 2019, ISRO incorporated additional instruments into this mission. But why was it named the Aditya L1 mission? The Sun is known by various names, including Aditya. The term L1 refers to the Lagrangian point 1, a location in space where the gravitational forces of the Earth and the Sun balance each other and become zero. This equilibrium allows satellite to remain relatively stable in their position. There are 5 Lagrangian points surrounding the Sun, with L1 being the most optimal for observing the Sun. The primary objective of the Aditya L1 mission will be to study the outer atmosphere of the Sun. To achieve this, ISRO will focus on studying the Sun's chromosphere and corona, the outermost layers. With the Aditya L1 mission, ISRO aims to investigate the phenomena of coronal heating, which pertains to the higher temperature of the corona layer compared to the intermediate layers. Additionally, the mission seeks to solve the mystery of the factors leading to the formation of coronal mass ejections. Through the Aditya L1 mission, ISRO will endeavor to enhance our understanding of the plasma environment surrounding the Sun and gain insights into the broader impact of these processes on the entire solar system. ISRO will send 7 instruments in the Aditya L1 mission, which will aid in studying the atmosphere and the outer layers of the Sun. Using a visible emission line chronograph, this instrument functions by blocking the intense sunlight emitted by Sun. It then employs filters to concentrate on distinct wavelengths of the light. Subsequently, the instrument generates images that assist us in studying temperature variations on the Sun. The Aditya mission includes the Aditya Solar Wind Particle Experiment and the Plasma Analyzer Package. These instruments comprise various sensors that aid in studying different properties of the solar wind, helping us understand its diverse characteristics. The Solar Ultraviolet Imaging Telescope will capture images of the Sun in the ultraviolet wavelengths. Through this, we can observe the Sun's chromosphere and gain insights into the transition layer between the chromosphere and the corona. The Solar Low Energy X-ray Spectrometer and High Energy L1 Orbiting X-ray Spectrometer instruments aid us in studying the X-ray emitted by Sun. The magnetometer instrument assists us in measuring the strength and direction of the magnetic field. This instrument will be utilized to study the magnetic field of the Sun. ISRO will launch Aditya L1 from the Satish Dhawan Space Center in Sriharikota. The satellite will be positioned in a low Earth orbit. Subsequently, the satellite's orbit will gradually transition into an elliptical shape. Then, utilizing the onboard thruster, the satellite will adjust its trajectory to enter the orbit around the L1 point of the Sun-Earth system. The satellite will ultimately be stationed in a halo orbit around L1. From this vantage point, Aditya L1 will observe the Sun for next 5 years. Please support our mission of making scientific knowledge accessible to everyone by sharing this video, like the video and subscribe to this channel. And see you in the next video. Bye-bye.